Personal distinct job individuals, you have to get a fine year and go undergo the workings of your department. You don't get to the top table of a government, any government, if anything you can get to them. This doesn't mean you vote or not vote for them. As ministers, it's your duty to toe the line with respect to the governing party's policy platform. And I'm not the kind of girl who votes for a friend with you that I'd like to share a view with. I happen to suspect that you'd quite like to move in Poland. But I find it critically reassuring to confirm that, however misguided I might privately think some of our government qualities must be, at least you will be impressed to be given enthusiasm and appeal by first-class overachievers, because it fits the alternative. In addition to the political lobbies, there is a small coterie of lower-level drones and minor flappers. Commissioner of Police, London's Property Chief. A female assistant commissioner, attending on behalf of ACPO, the Association of Chief Police Officers, the Chief Secretary to the Cabinet Office, representatives from the Prison Service, and so on. It's all a bit intimidating. I feel like the secondary school football coach is being summoned to a meeting with the Birmingham League chairman, who are, of course, very busy men. And you're due to know it. Dr. O'Brien. The deputy PM starts up slowly without any social reputation. Can you tell us exactly what happened in Chicago Square this morning? I stand up and deliver the cover story that the incorrigible committee squirted their skulls over for me while I was in the room for the team to share at lunchtime. I'm used to being a hard person. This is really cool.
Yeah, go left. Get down to 434 and then take the next bridge.
What a broad strategy for managing the superpower. Unfortunately, we currently have neither the budget nor the enabling legislative framework to implement the plan. But you hold it on my desk by 9 a.m. sharp next Monday. Thank you. Armstrong stepped to his English. Reflections from the candles in the middle of the table. He broke into the vault, moving to the secure computer system the bank uses to generate the number of banknotes. It's an anti-forgery feature. The real numbers aren't purely sequential. They are random. The actual sequence number and the cryptographic hash function generated on a very large computer. Thank you. utilities back at the new annex. But just as I'm about to dial, it vibrates to announce an incoming call. So it's for the Faraday cage. There's a familiar face on the screen, and for a heart-stabbing moment, I consider not answering. But no, that's not an option. Bob? No. I heard about the news. Where are you? Where are you staying? I haven't been back home since yesterday lunchtime. Our words collide and overlap in a birefringent sheen of ripples. Perhaps that's just my eyes. I stop and listen, clinging to the phone as if it's a lifesaver. It's a roof. The fire extinguishers were triggered. There's water damage and other stuff. Second floor. While the crime scene fell to orbit over, I'm crashing on my office floor. What a sleeping bag. If they want me to return to Anderson's office and get into the moments, it could take some time. How about you? I twirl in place, very slowly. Is he sleeping in the office to avoid me? Or avoid Lecter? That's the question. They've given me a corner office. Great view, shame about the furniture. Emma said she'd start sending people over this afternoon, but unless facilities get here first, I've got nowhere to put them. I realise dismally that we're talking about work. Retreating into the routine to avoid dealing with the uncanny rift that's opened up between us. I need moral support. Can we meet up somewhere? Yes, but you said you haven't been home. Paparazzi, dear. Did you be spooky? Snap. I knew I'd forgotten something. Horrid little clean bag. Yes, but that was yesterday. And you were going to clean the litter tray and I can't go home. I'm horribly busy and the journalists were doorstepping. Just stop.
Thank you.
after that. I'm back on my throne by the time the door opened. Hello? A hipsterish head, mid-twenties male, owlish black horn-rimmed spectacles, and highly ironic beard oozes round the doorframe, followed shortly thereafter by a hipsterish body. Dr. O'Brien? Arnie Samuel Jennings? Emma McGillis? She did it. Now look at her. There's probably a pretty long bell clogging up a windbox, but I need to get her. Thank you. The door is being shut behind my deck to the left and with a solid fist. I fear. He calculated angle from distances. It doesn't look good. The actor is about 3 meters behind my chair, leaning against the corner to the window. I don't have a gun or a knife. The facilities haven't installed the security walls in this room yet. I'm too panicked. Even if I had a hotline to the blue pictures on the front door, very much doubt I could get here in time to go. This morning is foolish. Theatrical music. Hyperia.